Ladies and gentlemen, it's on with the action and our eighth bout of the evening. This bout is the ICO Lightweight Title Eliminator held under 155 pounds. And our first fighter making his way to the cage and into the blue corner. Put your hands together for Andy Smudge Smith! And his opponent making his way to the red corner. John Ninja Black! Ladies and gentlemen, your official introductions for this ICO Lightweight Title Eliminator. First fighter standing to my right in the blue corner. This fighter is 33 years of age, stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, and weighted at 152.6 pounds. He has a record of 3-3-1. Hails from Sunderland and represents Combat Athlete. He is Andy Smudge Smith! And across the cage in the red corner, this fighter is 28 years of age, stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, and weighed in at 152.8 pounds. He has a record of 2-3-0, hails from Aberdeen, and represents Street Combat System. He is John Ninja Black! His title eliminator is held over 3 4-minute rounds.
So the final of our ICO title eliminator trios. We see John Black in the black and red shorts against Andy Smith in the black shorts with a grey camouflage strip. Contested at 155 lightweight. If the other two are anything to go by, this once again should be an explosive encounter.
John Black looking very relaxed, Ben.
He does look incredibly calm, doesn't he? A good observation there. Andy Smith looking to snap out some kicks. Black likes that head kick. Smith, excuse me.
Black in a very strange stance there, Ben. He's got his right hand low, almost a sort of traditional martial arts type of stance there. Obviously in a southpaw point of view from a boxer's stance.
So another nice kick coming forward from Smith. He's really, you can tell he's got an experience, some form of kickboxing pedigree, because those kicks are really smooth. I like the way he's snapping through and following over with the hip.
Yeah, and the kick, to the inside is such an effective weapon if you're a if you're facing a southpaw fighter like John Black.
Still flicking those kicks out quite nicely. Black coming forward, getting clipped as he does so. Smith really turning the aggression up now, but a nice reversal up and over with a big takedown.
Black regains guard very well.
Calmness of Black there, Dave, was extraordinary as he fell backwards there for that takedown. He knew he was going to end up in the guard position, so he was able to work. But the composure he showed as he was falling down, just took the head slightly.
Looking for the armbar, Ben.
And he's extended that quite nicely. Got a good, a really, really good high guard there. Very busy. He looks to turn in. Maybe looks to roll through if he can. But a very good defense from Smith.
Back is John Black.
Black really using that half guard well, but Smith, to be fair to him, is doing the right thing. It's a real scramble for position at this point. Black got to be careful and not giving his back up.
Black working well, Ben. We've seen some fighters tonight not working that well off their back, having the back flat to the floor. Smith, although he's got crushing top control here, John Black is doing very well to keep the fight moving. He's constantly moving Andy Smith's weight around, meaning he can't relax and even begin to think about landing any strikes.
Definitely. It's a very good point there. He's making the most of all the weapons that he's got. And like you say, very seldom he's lying flat. Even now, looking, he's on his back, but he's looking to isolate an arm. He's picking an arm in order to attack, looking to cradle upwards. And he's sat up out of that position very well, and now he'll be looking to sprawl if he can. Smith chases his man down, though, and lands a good shot to the body. It's Black on the bottom, once again looking to work. A real technical battle this, Dave.
Certainly, Ben. It's two very different grappling styles. Smith looking to get control, already looks to pass the half guard there of John Black. Black blocking it with the arm.
Definitely, I mean, it's definitely a case of the, almost for me, Dave, the technician versus the grinder. And as I say that, a great reversal from Black that sees him in the mount position, but a counter reversal from Smith.
An excellent show of grappling skill from both guys right now. I was going to be interested, Ben, to see what John Black's control was like on top, but we didn't have enough chance to look for it. And now is he looking for a go-go plata there?
It did look like he was going for a go-go plata from that position. That's high-level grappling to be confident enough to even attempt a submission like that. And like you say, I think my observation of the technician versus the grinder is really coming to pass as we move to the end of it. End of the round array, it's really fast pace.
John Black looking to secure the sweep, and he does again from that half-guard position. Good round.
Great show of respect at the end.
For me, Ben, I guess you've got to give Andy Smith the round for being maybe on top in control. It's hard to see how the judges can score against him, although John Black was so active off his back, just a very, very close round. I mean, I could almost lean towards a 10-10 maybe.
Definitely. I mean, both fighters, I think, had the moments. And John Black, although he was taken down, showed great presence of mind off his back. And like you say, it was the fact that he never laid flat for me. He worked to that, from the half guard position, he was sitting up straight away. And Smith, a good ground and pounder, really didn't have the time to settle into his strikes, didn't have the time to kind of make the most of his position. And that's the problem, really.
Yeah, John Black looks very 10th planet jiu-jitsu in the way he's working. You know, he went for the go-go plata. He seems to like to work from that half guard, using that lockdown position. Andy Smith, more traditional, looking to pass guard, get that top position, use that shoulder to get some pressing top control. It's a very, very interesting mix of grappling styles here, Ben, and a very entertaining fight here on Pace Control 6.
We come out for the second round. Smith in the grey camouflage. John Black in the red and black. Smith throwing those kicks. I mean, we can see that's where his preference is. He's shown some great tie with the pushing kicks and the turning kicks. Black really needs to do is, if he feels confident with the timing, what he needs to do is when his opponent maybe turns his back or commits to a big kick, he needs to move in and close the range, trying to limit the effectiveness. And Smith landing some good shots now, really turning it on, standing up.
John Black, he's definitely looking for that big left hook from the back of his stance. Andy Smith doing well to keep busy.
Oh, and there's a
nice
big knee.
Knee.
I think Black just got out of there in time and landed a nice uppercut of his own. And now both of them against the cage looking to threaten. A lovely go behind there. Black will be looking to get this fight to the ground. And he's got that control. And maybe fishing under for the rear naked choke, almost standing up, giving something else to think about. As he's got one hook in there on the right hand side. And now he's sacked. And now it's Smith who's gone to the canvas, but not of his own volition. As Black's looking to work, trying to get that left hook in.
Andy Smith needs to turn into his man. Black does excellently.
That's
there.
That's very good back control for me to not get booked off at that point.
He's going to be looking to get that second hook in or maybe secure a body triangle.
Definitely, but Smith doing very well there and rolling through. But this is where Black wants this fight, you can tell. The aggressive submission game that he showed, the technical grappling. And as you're right, he's got his mouth flattened out. He's really looking to put that choke in. Referee Neil all having a very close look at the action. And that looks very tight. He's thinking about tapping, and there's the tap. Unbelievable. What a finish from John Black. The second he got the fight to the floor, and it was on his terms, he was able to put the fight exactly where he wanted it.
Yeah, excellent, excellent performance from both guys. Very interesting styles. Both guys were polar opposites, whether it was on the floor or stood up. Both very different styles, and it came together for a great fight. Andy Smith didn't make too many mistakes. It's just that in the end, John Black was just too good for him on the ground. Once he secured that back, he showed excellent back control and eventually secured the choke. But for me, Ben, Andy Smith, he looks frustrated in the ring there. He's got nothing to be ashamed of in that performance. He's just come across a guy in John Black who looks very dangerous on the floor.
Definitely. I mean, it was the technical side of it that he really struggled with. Black using a few unorthodox techniques that are very hard to deal with, and a great win.
Ladies and gentlemen, in our eighth bout of the evening, ICO lightweight title eliminator at 1 minute 48 seconds of the second round, your winner by way of rear naked choke in the red corner, John Black. Put your hands together, a gallant opponent in Andy Smith.